picture comprehension, learning objectives of picture composition. In this lesson, you will learn how to describe a picture in English. A picture composition involves writing sentences based on a given picture or set of pictures. Before we begin writing, we need to carefully observe the picture. Arrange the observation points in a logical order. Write meaningful sentences to form a composition. Write a title to the composition based on the main theme of the picture. So let's begin. Question answers related to picture. Here's the picture on which I am going to write few sentences, few question answers. Look the picture carefully. What is happening in the picture? The children are celebrating a birthday party. Second, whose birthday party is it? It is Minnie's birthday party. Minnie is the name of a girl. Remember, we can also give another name to the birthday girl because it is not mentioned. Third question, how many candles are there on the cake? There are 7 candles on the cake. What is Mrs. Lal doing? Mrs. Lal is giving a storybook to Minnie. She is Mrs. Lal. Same rule that we use for Minnie is applied for Mrs. Lal here. We can also give another name for her. What things are on the table? There are sandwiches, potato chips, pizzas, juice, and few gifts are on the table. These question and answers help us to describe the picture in detail. Based on these points, we can now write a composition of around 7 to 8 sentences. So let's begin by giving a title to the composition. Minnie's birthday party. Remember, title is very important part for a composition. Minnie is celebrating her birthday. She has invited all the girls and boys in her class to a party. Her friends giving her card and presents. Mrs. Lal is giving a storybook to Minnie. There is a big chocolate cake with 7 candles is on the table. There are also sandwiches, potato chips, pizzas and juice. The children are having lots of fun in Minnie's birthday party. That is easy, wasn't it? We have written a composition based on various elements within one picture. Let's move on to learn how to write a story based on 2 or more pictures. You can see I have given you 3 pictures over here. So first, we need to find the common element in these pictures. In the first picture, we can see a lion is resting under a tree and a small mouse scurried up on the lion's back. In the second picture, the lion got up angrily and caught the mouse in his paw. In the third picture, the lion was trapped in a hunter's net and the mouse nibbling at the net with great speed. From these images, it is clear that the jungle is the common animal in these pictures. Let's do some questions that come to our mind after looking at the picture. Where is the scene located? The scene is located in the middle of the jungle. Who is sleeping in the first picture? A lion is sleeping in the first picture. How did the lion wake up from sleep? A small mouse ran over the lion's back. The lion got up angrily and caught the mouse. How did the mouse flee the lion? The mouse chewed the rope of the net to free the lion. Now, let's make a paragraph like a story with this picture. Remember, write the composition or a story in the past tense only. Then, we must begin with the main title of the story, The Lion and the Mouse. Once a lion was sleeping in a forest. Mouse started playing on it. Lion caught the mouse and tried to crush it to death. Mouse said, "Sorry," and he will help him in future. Lion left the mouse. One day, lion got caught in hunter's net. He roared loudly for help. Mouse came and cut net with his sharp teeth. Moral: mercy brings its reward. Always help others. At the end of this lesson, you will be able to write several sentences after looking at a picture. Thank you. Have a nice day.